Typically, it's done in collaboration with the patient, family, and the psychiatrist and psychiatric nurse. You know, in the process of being assessed, you know, one thing that needs to be reviewed is the level of risk. Is there any acute symptoms that puts the person at imminent risk of doing something harmful to themselves or others, or puts them at risk of deterioration? So if that risk is there, then they would typically get admitted. If it's not there and the person has a degree of insight that they understand that they have an illness, they're kind of motivated to get care, they may have symptoms that are fairly challenging, but if they have the insight, there's no risk, and they're motivated, then piecing together a plan that gets them the level of treatment that they want from home is really the best treatment. And that would come from, you know, the treating team kind of putting together a plan that's going to address all the needs. And typically family or friends of the patient will give some feedback on whether they think that plan is doable or not, because they're the best reference points on whether the patient is motivated or whether they're just feigning motivation to get home.